Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. We are going to talk about E1 reactions on alcohols. So for the E1 reaction, if you're watching these videos in order, you've seen this done on a halide. So for the halide, we simply take a highly substituted halide, we warm this up, and if the conditions are all right, we will lose our halogen, in this case a chloride, we'll make a carbocation. This is a nice, stable, tertiary carbocation. There's also a resonance stabilization with the benzene ring next door. And once we form the carbocation, carbocations can do two things. They can get attacked by a nucleophile, or they can lose a beta hydrogen. Attacking with a nucleophile would simply take us backwards, and we're not going to go backwards, we're going to go forwards, so we're going to lose a beta hydrogen, and there will be some base in this reaction. If you wanted to use the chloride, you could use the chloride. We'll lose this beta hydrogen to the carbocation, and we'll form our alkene. Almost the exact same thing happens with alcohols instead of halides. So alcohols, however, we don't have a good leaving group. So we're going to protonate first. So we will always have an acid in these reactions. And our strong acid, in this case I'm using sulfuric acid, will protonate our alcohol. Oops. I cheated a couple carbons out of there. Let's get that right. Our acid will protonate the alcohol, and now we have our leaving group, and that's typically our problem with the alcohols. We don't have a leaving group, but if we protonate, we can get a leaving group, and then this can leave, and this will make the exact same carbocation that we saw up top. Our carbocation intermediate, and this will lose a beta hydrogen. I'm just going to write minus a beta hydrogen. That is not a mechanism, but that's what happens, and it happens just as we showed up here with the halide reaction. So what are some notes to take from this E1 reaction? One, we need a good carbocation. That's always true for any SN1 or E1 reaction, so highly substituted is going to be better. Also note the acid. We will typically use sulfuric acid or phosphoric acid for this. We will avoid acids that have nucleophilic counterions, like HCl has halide, a chloride. Chloride can attack the carbocation. We don't want to have a bunch of bromide from HBr or iodide from HI. So to solve that problem, we'll use sulfuric acid or phosphoric acid because they have very non-nucleophilic conjugate bases. And those are really the main points. We can take alcohols, heat them up in the presence of a strong acid, no solvent is necessary, and we will drive off water and form our E1 alkene product.